I just feel something different for you, but I like you.
You're Diana Ross, baby.
Ross.
Yeah. That's a big compliment.
Diana Ross has had a big career, and I'm singing one of her songs called When You Tell Me That You Love Me. I can't wait to do it. It's such a beautiful song.
I'll make you safe no matter where you are.
Stop it right there. That's good.
Can't believe that I'm working with Ronnie Jerkins. He's worked with Mariah Carey, to Keisha, to Monica. It's just amazing.
Stronger!
Woo!
Are you sure?
Yes.
I've never went that high in a song before.
You gotta open it up, yes. Open it up.
It's my first time singing this high.
But you're doing it. That means it can be done. So we gonna push you, here we go.
I'm just glad that they're taking me to a place that I've never been.
I was slightly nervous about the range of her voice, about being able to take the top end note. Her and Rodney worked on it and did a really great job. I was so inspired that I wanted to invite Berry Gordy from Motown to watch us sing that song tonight because it was just beautiful.
I want to call the stars down from the sky. I want to live a day that never dies. I want to change the world. For you, all the impossible I wanna do. And baby, every time you touch me, I become a hero. I'll make you safe no matter where you are, and bring you everything you ask for. Nothing is above me. I'm shining.
Yo, listen, I tell you what, I liked it. Berry is here, the great Berry Gordy, one of the greatest ever in the music industry, ever. And listen, I tell you what, I was a little worried seeing the song that you were doing because I was like, well, you know, I don't know how this is going to go or whatever. But I got to tell you what, it sounded like it was a little bit of a safe move. But you know what? I actually liked it because I saw you grow a little bit more as a singer as you paid attention to the notes when you were going a little sharper flat. You pulled it back in with the vibrato. So I think you actually did yourself some good with that. I liked it.
And I agree with Randy. I think there's a lot more in there than you're showing us and that you're going to. So I got confidence in you.
You're just, you know, you're so elegant up there. And we are seeing what a real professional you are, you know, already. You know, he's right. You know, there was moments where it was kind of like getting away from you and you pulled it back in and you kept your composure and you did it. Now I want to start seeing you sing songs that we can kind of sing along with you. I think the past couple of weeks you've done songs that maybe people don't know as well. You know, some Diana Ross songs, you know, everybody knows. I would have maybe liked to see that, but still, I love you and I think that you're amazing. You're awesome.
Thank you.
Let's hear it for Ashton. Hey, last week when we saw your face and you were like, it's me, and ran across this stage was a moment. How has that changed the way you sing when you're up here?
Well, you know, I don't know. I don't want people to look at me as just an edge all the time. I want people to see the soft side of me, you know, the elegant side. Who Ashton Jones really is.
And you're back with that second chance. If you want to vote for Ashton, 1-866-IDOL-03. It's 1-866-436-5703. Or you can text the word vote to 5703. Also, vote online at AmericanIdol.com. Good luck, darling. Thank you very much.